Hello, so this is a review of the game. I'll just get to the interesting part of it. So the game is kind of like a 7 out of 10, with a mention that it's an original game. It's kind of hard to play and to understand, but once you get going, you'll never be stopped. Besides, it's so much fun just to unlock all the crazy stuff you have over here. Now, let's speak about the things that people don't like about the game, and if you still want to buy it after all of that, well, you'll be in for a big surprise. Now, first of all, people don't like the game because it's not exactly as advertised, because you need to play about 5 hours, 6 hours, 10 hours to get to the point where you have a big base and manage it and have a lot of little drakes to care for. So this is basically like an adventure game where you move out of your base and go to different islands and then connect them via waypoints so they can bring resources back to your base. Certain resources. So people didn't play enough, so they think that the game is mostly about grinding and, you know, feeding your little drakes. But later on you'll have a fully autonomous base like this one. I mean, we have water, we have food, we have everything here, and they are having fun, and that's what matters. So the camp management, it's rough in the beginning because you'll need to produce food, and to produce food you'll need seeds. So I guess most of the complaints about the game being grindy are from people who didn't play a lot of the game. About 10% of the people playing the game actually reached this amount of development that you can see over here, which is very, very low. So you have to manage water, food and happiness or fun for the little guys. This is what they consume, this is what you produce, and this is what you have in your base. This is the tech tree. Another thing they don't really like about the game is the lack of enemy diversity, so you only have 3 enemies to fight in the game. Well, there will be more, I think, but the main 3 enemies will always be the same. And combat is a little stiff, so that locks me into my animation. I can move backwards. So if you hit once, you can move backwards. It's a little harder to explain, but it also has that system where you have a ranged weapon and a melee one, plus your consumable. So again, the more you play the game and the further you go into the game, the better it will become, because you have more consumables. And I don't just mean the ones I have on me. So again, it's one of the reasons people... it's not a grindy game, you'll just have to figure it out for yourself. So later on we'll have proximity mines, I mean you can build one right now. Also have healing totems, Saint Elmo's fire. Yeah, burning away brambles. This will be very helpful later. And also this is ammunition, and you can also create an infinite amount of enemies. Summoning a new group of brothers. I guess it's only a group, but I think it will be fun. Also, when you finish this world, this is not everything in the game. When you finish this world, you can go into another one. Leave region. So that means you'll go into a new map with new islands, new challenges, and probably stronger enemies. I don't want to spoil what's beyond the first island. But as a little hint, if you look on the tech tree, you'll see that we have some thermal things. So yeah, you can suspect some winter maps. It's a bigger portion of the camp. So the more you level up your drakes, the more you have to increase your camp. So that's the camp budget. You get more camp budget and you can use more skills. We have Lucky Trader and Opportunity. So each of the drakes can give you a skill. And in the beginning you can only have one skill, so that's why combat will seem sluggish, because you don't have all of these. And you also have a trader which will sell you most of the things you can grind. So, for example, you can sell branches, you can sell leaves, and you can get back, you know, interesting items. Like, for example, ammunition, or the things you need to build the waypoints. And you can also build... That's a little problem I have right now. And you can also build on the fly, so you don't need to be in your base, only build it once and then you can build it anywhere. So for example, glowstone and duct tape. And this guy is always here. So you'll have the duct tape and the glowstone. I mean, he doesn't have a lot of it, but he usually has a little bit of everything. So let's buy the ammunition. And let's say a cluster, because that's what we have right now. Now we'll see the enemies, and the enemies will be the ones you'll face throughout most of the game. There will be some differences. And again, this is not a very goofy game, it's not a Chella game. You have a blunderbuss, you have a bow, and then you have a balloon launcher. You can also build defenses later on, like Tesla towers, ballista towers that your drakes can use. And now they'll hide. We have to protect them. That's an 11, level 11 one. He's very tough. Okay, let's get our best weapon out. Oh, that fence is destroyed. That's why it looks like that. So yeah, a lot of people are actually discouraged because you have to do a lot in the beginning, but it'll get so much more easy as time passes, especially because you'll find new weapons, you'll have more ammunition. And you also have player progression, which means you'll increase your player health on top here. As you can see, I have quite a few health because I raised a lot of drakes. We have a block, we have a dodge, we have a ranged weapon, we have a combo, and we can switch our weapons on the fly. Now if you're wondering why they're not attacking me, well, because that's why I have a lot of walls, and I also have some buildings that will attract the enemies. So yeah, these are decoys and they should attack it first. So that's why they get stuck sometimes, but I think on the other maps, if we leave this map, they'll be harder. Let me show you the blunderbuss. And also the weapons have tiers, they have crude, nice and serious. So that's why the damage different, that's nice, that's serious. Okay, who's messing up my base? Okay, as you can see, they drop a lot of main resources. Like I said, later on you'll have base defenses, electrified fences, and so much crazy stuff. Yeah, they are kind of stuck because they don't know what to do with the information. I'm playing very bad right now. Okay, we only have one enemy left. And if they enter your base, they can destroy all your buildings, so don't let them inside, otherwise it'll go very bad for you. And after you finish an island or an encounter like that, they give you a chest. And you need to unlock, you need the schematics to unlock all the building stuff. As you can see, you have pinball machines, and let me show you the ballista that the drakes can use, so that'll be more interesting. Also, you need to, you know, manage their stats. And the last one is the electrified fence. As you can see, this is also a serious one. It's a one-handed weapon. The Weed Walker is a two-handed weapon. They have some stats. So in order to fix the weapons, you just need to drop them on the ground and the drakes will do it. But just look at how cute they are. And you have lobster farms to feed them. Now, most of the buildings will become redundant over time, so that's why you have to advance, unlock schematics, go to other places. And the main way to travel to the places I'm telling you about is like this. And this is what players are complaining about, but you can buy the items, you can farm the items, you can find everything you need without stopping the game for grind. But said you'll have to explore all the islands, because sometimes they will have hidden rewards. For example, some of them will have schematics, each island has one or two schematics, some of them will have weapons, some of them will have secret stashes of stones. And by stones I mean stones you need to upgrade your little drakes. These ones. Quartz, kyanite and so on. And you probably have figured out, so the islands are pretty different, but mainly there is an open space with brambles that you have to destroy or thorns. Sometimes it's 4 of these guys, only they have a little fog, sometimes it's 25, depends on the map really. Now let's get back to our base. Sometimes you have a factory, sometimes you have a little house, sometimes you have the lighthouse like it's over there. I'll not explore those too much because I want to show more of the mechanics instead. So you can press X to inspect, so as you can see this is kind of like the management mode. This is a hot tub, they enjoy it. So this produces happiness or fun for them. This produces dirty water, this produces drinking water, and this produces food with electricity and clean water. It's kind of complicated later on. And you can also see, you can give this guy one stone or one precious stone. So let's say you give him a crystal, and this is how you evolve them. This one is mature. You just have to give them 5. Oh yeah, you'll get closer to leveling up your camp, food, water and entertainment. Yes, it's ready. Actually, I finished the tutorial, but it's showing me now the tutorial. Like, I guess it's okay. So we have a 60% chance of a critical attack because I choose him as the buff giver. Actually, I didn't choose him. Where is my buff giver? This one is one. And they also give you the charms. I don't know what's after mature, but I think they'll look a little funnier. So each of them is pretty unique looking. Well, unless you get copies, but that's kind of rare. I don't think you can get copies. So this is one guy that I have a perk from. Oh, he ran away. Anyway, because if you level them up, you'll get more levels in your perks. So that's how you make progression in the game. You increase your health by raising your camp level and you increase the skills by just, you know, leveling up these guys. And it also shows you when you can level one up. I'm just telling you this because it will get very grindy later on and you need to practice a lot. So they will give you 50 of the charms. So this is camp resources. Wood, brick, cloth, scrap metal, circuits, and shiny objects that you use as currency. These are your schematics. So these are only camp resources. They don't go into your inventory. Your inventory is only used for crafting, weapons and so on. So yeah, this is about it. You'll also fight some bosses and some other stuff, but mainly this is what the game is all about. And the base will get even more crazy, like I said, as you can see these guys grow up to be beautiful Pokemons. And later they should be able to send you back home. Yeah, so if you enjoy the game and if you want to have a little game that's more about exploring, fighting, defending your base, creating a base and also finding secret stuff in the wilderness, well, this is for you. Also, you can use your bunk beds. I mean, these guys can have bunk beds and yoga balls. And you can use them to snipe. With the bow, of course. If you don't hit the enemy, you can actually recover some of the arrows. So again, they have a lot of mechanics going for them. The developers are really smart about it. See you next time. Bye.